We have a customer who wants to be able to plate quite a few pairs of these. And this is a medical instrument that's made of stainless steel. We've masked the handle as they just want from here down to be gold and not the rest. What we have here is the Jewel Master option 2, except we have swapped out the activator for our Trival Acid Gold Strike and the platinized titanium anode, as those are what we're going to need to do the stainless steel in this case. That will allow us to apply the gold directly to the stainless steel with no nickel in between the gold and stainless steel, as you would have with like a Woods nickel strike. In the medical field, that's pretty important. And then we have our 24K bright gold here and our electrocleaner here. So for this situation, we're going to be using the common lead to clip to the part instead of hanging it from these bus bars like you would if you had some jewelry hanging on a rack. So we're just going to go ahead and swing these bus bars out of the way so that they're not in the way. And we're just going to get to it. I have the machine already set at 8 volts, and I think I'll just clip right here and we'll start by electrocleaning. So with medical grade stainless steel like this, we want to electroclean at least 7 volts. And probably if you want to play it safe, you would do this for, I'd say, a minute, maybe even a minute and a half if you started to have some sort of adhesion problem. Also, something you can do to speed it up is to heat up the electrocleaner. A lot of times I'll recommend to people they get like a microwave and set it near, and so you can just heat up your solutions really quick. You can heat this up to, you know, 150 degrees, and it really speeds up this process right here and makes the electrocleaner work better. However, the electrocleaner does also work fine at room temperature. You just may need to go a little bit longer. I think we've probably gone long enough, but just to make sure that it works for this demonstration, we'll go for another minute. Now, if you don't do this step on stainless steel, there's no way the gold's going to adhere. You may get it to deposit onto there, but then if you were to pull it out and put a piece of scotch tape to it and pull it off, it would just rip right off. So the electrocleaning is really the very first important critical step. All right, let's pull it out, go into the first rinse, and into the second rinse. And here I'll just look and make sure that it's staying wet everywhere. Looks great, it looks all nice and wet out. We've explained that in other videos. You want it to stay wet everywhere. If you have any areas where the water beads up or falls off, then you need to electroclean longer. Okay, now we're gonna go into the Trival. And for the Trival, we wanna do it more at about 6 volts. So I'm just gonna turn that down and go right into it and agitate. So you wanna move it around in this strike. You don't have to do this, but it works best. And we're only gonna do this for probably 5 to 10 seconds. Just tell it tinted gold. See, you can probably see it's just lightly tinted. That's all we're looking for. It's called a strike. So we'll rinse and rinse. And now we're gonna go into the actual plate. So we turn the voltage down for the gold plating. We wanna be about 2.8 while plating. So I'll set it to 3.5 because once we put this in, it will drop. So we put it in, it's now at 2.5. I'll turn it up to 2.75, sounds good. 2.7 and 2.8 are really the sweet spot. Now you could leave this in here for 5, 10 minutes, even 15 minutes if you wanted to. And just the longer you leave it, the thicker the gold gets. For the purposes of this video, I'll just keep it short because if you look, it's already gold. Turns gold nearly instantly. So we'll just go another 5 or 10 seconds. And within 5.5 minutes, you'll get a micron of the 24K hardened gold, which would be quite thick. I think for these people, they'll probably want to do 0.5 micron or 20 micro inches. And so we rinse it, and as you can see, it's a beautiful 24K gold. And then inside and out, and even in this little hinge right there, it's all plated nicely. And so what I'll do now is I'll just take the electrical tape off, and this would be a completed instrument. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, comment on the video, give us a call, write us an email, and we're happy to answer them. Thank you for watching.